I think, Jutta, I know the horse, I know you. Maybe you talk first to the spectators so that they know who is Jutta Lee and who is your horse.
And to be honest, we had a
couple of years ago, a clinic here in Cindy and Steve's place for FEI trainer. And the main subject was working at hand. And to be honest, for me, it is more important to write proper transition, mainly from trot to walk. And when you do this in a proper way with a good rhythm and with a good elasticity as she's doing it, this is the very step into the direction to ride a horse at the end of the day in a proper, piaf, or to be honest, to say half steps. And now look, especially to the hind legs. The hind legs are a little bit lazy, and she rides the transitions with the idea, the picture which she had in her head, that he moves enough from behind in the transition. That is, look to the hind legs, come on. And this is a smooth transition. Good. That's it. Uphill, under control, balanced, good rhythm, and in front of the rider's legs. Again, this is what a young horse, a very young horse, has to learn. It has nothing more. The head higher, more open. These are second and third things. But to be in front of the rider, this is the very, 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 very first goal each horse has to learn. The quarter horse, the morgen horse, this is a horse from the south part of Germany, Baden-Württemberg, very, very south, southwest, close to the border of France. Very good. So, I changed the rein, maybe with one hand. Good. Okay. It was a proper transition into war. To be honest, she was riding the transition with her driving aid. She was not finishing the canter, she was starting the walk. He gets right, the camp just on the left hand, that he gets a good body feeling. Jutta from big strides into smaller strides. Or maybe you used in the beginning the whole arena. Big strides. Nose line enough in front so that the horse will stretch his neck to balance his body. Horse name, a glorious feeling. And the more you do this, the more glorious the feeling will for him. He will have a glorious feeling, and I think it's a glorious feeling in the center as well. A little bit more flexion. He is a little bit crooked on the left hand. Not very much. And Jutta, try to ride more deep into the corner. Or that you use a little bit more your inside leg. And this is very important. She's riding on a high level. But this is, therefore it's good that someone is looking from time to time. Because the left hand, she is not riding as correct as on the right-hand side. Not as deep into the right on the right-hand side. And these small pieces, at the end of the day, are important to ride in a good way. Oh, very good. It's a little bit fresh, a little bit too much forward, but this is, in this situation, exactly the right decision. Oh. And then with shoulder in, you slow down the tempo, deep into the corner, maybe you ride into the corner circle. Deep into the corner, the inside. In each corner, you're going to have the Volte Decker. Get into the Volte. Oh! Left the teeth. That you get a little bit more influence with your left leg on your on the left hand. Oh! That's good. Oh, now he's ready to stay on the circle and to make the circle smaller. At the end of the day, the rider is producing the horse. The better he sits, the more is, the more independent he can sit from his hands, and the better the whole situation is. Very good.
Yeah.
Give all reins. Oh! The more you use the reins, the more you hold with your reins and with the bit the horse you want to stop the horse, the more the horse fights against it and the more negative it is. Very good.
Yeah.
Top class. And you swing into the trot. Oh, into trot. Stay on the small circle. Oh, and into canter left. And into trot. Stay on the small circle. One hand. Oh, and he uses his hind legs more in the trot work. A little bit lazy behind. Oh, but and into trot. But. And once more. Nee, that the very first step is a step from behind. Ich habe so ein bisschen mehr durchschieben. Im Trab. So. And come. From behind. Into the trot. Oh. Into the trot. You swing into the trot. With your left leg. With your left leg. With your left leg. With your left leg. Oh. Once more. Good. Very good. Now he's ready, from my point of view, to canter him a little bit with a higher degree of connection. Oh, now he starts to sit. Very good. And canter again. And trot again. And try to maintain Jutta the same size of the circle. Not bigger and smaller circle. And canter left. Good. Oh. Good. And in a trot. Good. Jawohl. Super. And canter left. To make these small pieces, or to ride these small pieces in a very high degree of harmony between the rider and the horse, this is the proper training to, yeah. Oh, very good. And once more. You see, she's using her body in a proper way. Oh, this is for me what you have to do. Last time when I saw him, this was in Pineland, in Maine, Pineland Farm, Maine. He was very, very hot. And Jutta was here the day before, and she didn't ride him for a couple of days. He was so hot. Jutta, super. But now you are on the level as I know it from last year. Super. And he's better than last year. I think if you agree, Jutta, that we do now a little bit to make him active. Shoulder in, half pass, shoulder in. A little bit this work. I think we begin. Then we do a little bit just for fun, because he loves flying changes, just for the spectator. Then maybe at the end, a little of half steps. That we don't do too much, but that we ask enough. No. And when you start to trot, he has to be active. No. Jawohl, that's it. But for me, it is very important, Jutta, that you always have the feeling the movement starts from behind. And a little bit more trot. Maintain. Exactly. This is one of my favorite movements. A shoulder in, half pass, shoulder in, half pass, to change it. Why is one of my favorite movements? Because the rider has to use mainly his inside leg, now shoulder in, and the horse has to bring the inside, his inside or her inside hind leg under the center of gravity. A half pass is not a natural movement, but you never will see a horse outside in the field, which is doing half passes. They do pirouettes and piaf and passage and flying changes, but no horse do a half pass. Therefore, it is very important to ride movements exactly like this to make it as come shoulder? At the shoulder? What for the shoulder? What for? What for? What for? Oh! That he is a little bit more active, a little bit more... Jutta, hind legs are in front, this is not okay. A little bit more, take the shoulder, the right shoulder with you. More forehead in front. Oh, that's better. That's now you start. Very good. And shoulder in again. Right leg, shoulder in. Right leg, right leg, right leg. Oh! And again. Same procedure. Come on. Right leg. Right leg. Oh, right leg. Oh! And start. See, for you as spectators in the pod, before you do half passes, you have to have a 100% safe shoulder in. Come on. That he moves by himself through the corners. Oh! At the end of the day, the whole training is a big gymnastic process, what Jutta is doing now. This is gymnastic for the horse. Oh, okay. Now, you can finish this. Come on, small. A little bit more shoulder in front. Little better. Good. And shoulder in. Very good. And then, Jutta, transition to canter run. Yeah, okay. Walk. Very good. Was a nice transition. The heat is key. Horse was moving with the hind legs. And then the horse was opening the jaw. Opening the jaws. That's very important. The German word is Ganaschenwinkel. Connection between head and mouth has to be very open. That makes it much more comfortable for the horse than to be the whole time moving with a short neck. And without a proper jaw. Not with not open jaw, no. Right leg, cup, 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 cup. No, and you're quick enough behind. This is a challenge, not to make the canter fast, but active behind, huh? No problem. No, that's it, active behind. With your pelvis, you give the horse a feeling to be in front, and with your legs, maybe the inside leg, you make it quick. So now, serpentines, four loops, three times, flying change, but crossing center line. Cup, 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 very good. A little bit high group tendency. This is, okay. And again. Okay, I will finish. I stop. Oh, good. And again now, five loops, four times flight changes. Cut, cut. He has to be in front. Look how she's sitting, how she's giving her aids. Very good. No problem. This I wasn't. It was not my fault. So, now six loops, five times five changes. Oh, very good. Yeah. Yeah. I think this is a marvelous movement because now she controls the horse pretty much. This is sometimes more difficult to ride this movement than to ride find changes on the diagonal every third stride or something like this. Very good. And she controls her horse with her inside leg. Top class. Very good. And then you're riding to walk and a short break. If you look how she is finishing the canter, though she starts the walk. And this is very important for you. When I say now let's transition to walk, not to do it from 1 second to another, Jutta was listening in a perfect way into the horse, and then when she had the feeling that now my horse is ready, then she was asking for the walk. And this is for me very important, that you do this a little bit with a clear picture in mind, not, oh, what, I use my reins. No, she was cantering into the walk, and when she had the feeling now the horse is ready, then she asked for the walk. Very good. And then she starts top class. Right leg. Oh, you can't tell that. This was, you just could see what she did with her inside leg, to make it a little bit sensitive in a friendly way. Oh, on the diagonal, three flying changes every fourth stride. Make a little mistake, so horse was not listening. I didn't do anything with my hands. I'm very careful. Stop. And again. Take your time. Good. Very good. This is very important that you, mainly that you control every third stride, five line changes, that you control the canter between each flight change. One. Four, five. Easy going. Now, seven flying changes every second stride. Oh, perfect. Oh. Easy. And now, nine flying changes at every stride. And you see, he loves it. Body language and voice means, oh, I'm happy, I love it. And yet she sits absolutely quiet. Oh, good. And start. No problem. Okay, we do it once more. No problem. Once more, good. And this is what I did say in the morning. The circle is the very best movement to control the horse and to connect the horse and to concentrate the horse. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Very good. A little bit haiku or a little bit of tension. Right. Once more, circle. Maybe you can lengthen the strides at the open side of the circle. Come. Oh! Good. He was a little bit tense in the flying changes. And now you can ride 9 or 11 if you have a good feeling. If not, then stop it and maybe a little bit medium canter in between. Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, super. This was excellent. Did you see how much the horse did jump through the body? And now you learn the highlight with one hand, and maybe you give me the whip. Oh. Yeah, you have a very, very good balance in the saddle. Good. Again, did you see how she was collecting the horse here? Collect from behind, and then she was able to ride with riding aids into the walk. Look. And now with one hand. This is really a big challenge. I don't think that we have many riders in the world who are able to ride flying changes at every stride with one hand. But when Jutta will have a freestyle, she should do this. Later on, be ready for this. Okay. I was too early. Take your time. Good. Well, now. That one. No problem. But no problem. Do it again. No problem, you're done. Good. Yeah. Oh, yes, to be uphill on our side. possible.
Yeah.
No problem. There was one mistake, Petim. One for bridge, short bridge. You see how sensitive a horse is. When a fly is on the skin of the horse is, doesn't hate it. And therefore you see, she just changed a little bit the way she was riding with her hands, and he was a little confused. Give him a short break and then do it again. I think this is I think it's not correctly. This is very important that you make the horses sensitive and that you try movements like this. And the more you're able to ride with one hand, the better. So once more. Canter left. Oh. Good. Yeah. Ego. Good. Okay. And when you want to do something like this, good. But exactly. Jutta, do what exactly? One and one. Always, it's a very important principle. Always when you have a problem, try to write a movement which is a bit easier. No. One and one. Oh, no problem. Now ready. Good. Good. And he has to stay, or he has to be uphill, not leaning on the bit, not to be strong for now. Easy. Okay, pat him once more and wait. Connect him with your position. Connect him. No, and he's not running away. No, and now. Good. Six. Super. And she is able to produce it, and I think it was very good when you said, that you now feel how much you should use your inside and outside seat bone. And the more you do movements like this, the more you know how much you have to ride with your pelvis and your seat bones. Very good. Right into the circle, smaller circle in the direction of pirouette, a little bit working pirouette, and then we change the rein and the same movement on the right hand side. Good. And give all reins. This is for me a super situation to practice a horse in the pirouette. Oh, thank you very much. It was not asking too much, but it was enough. The question was big enough. So, and now flying changes. Collective is a little bit too fresh. No, better. Collective, a little bit more. Collective. Oh! Jawohl! In the pirouette you need a special canter. In the flying change, in every stride you need a special tempo. Which is a little bit simple. No problem. It's a little bit of special tempo what you need instead of riding flying change every third or every fourth stride. So collect him a little bit more with your position. Collect him. Collect him. Hold up. Now ready. Okay. No problem. Give him a little bit flexion right. Once more, a little bit more. No. I think you will see it later on the screen. Give first flexion right. He has to accept the flexion. Flexion right. No, now. Okay, once more. The beginning was good, then there was a mistake. Good. Okay. Good. Oh, that's it. Oh. Jawohl. Six flying changes. Now a small piece. Now the horse had exactly the right flexion before you start and short. Yeah, no. Before we make a break, just right into the circle. That's good. Good. Yeah. In and out. Very good. Yeah. For me, this is classical way of training a horse on a very, very high level. Very good. Short break, and then I will give Jutta the whip, and then we want to see how she is producing the half steps, and because this was the challenge in the old days. I will see whether we have still the old days or we have now new days. Just to see what you are doing, good. And out. And Jutta, if I can give the advice, trot. You start in walk and then some half steps and then you trot. Come and trot. Come, trot. Why trot? Or canter. He's behind you. Or canter. Half steps are not a circus movement. He has to be in front of you. Oh, he has to be in front. Good, good, good. Good, and trot, and trot. Oh, he needs this feeling for good, 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 good. Come on, he's no rhythm. Trot, trot. Oh, good. And again, he has to be in front. Good, in front, he's on the front. In front, then canter. He has to be in front. Oh, good. Right into the trot. Good. And you ride into the walk. And then you start again. And Jutta, the principle is a little bit with this. And when he starts like this, then you trot. And give him a little bit a stretching feeling. Oh.
Good. Oh, and again. Good.
the ground. And I think when you do too much from the ground, then he kills his body. This is, for me, that's the very best way to school a dog. Look, that's it. The goal is to motivate the horse. He should do this by himself. He should have fun to do movements like this. Oh, you can't ride a horse in a piaf when the horse is not willing to do. Oh, and once more, I like it that she is stretching him, that he gives him such a good body feeling, and then I think it's enough. He has to start by himself. So, no, left leg, your left leg, come. Good. Jutta. And once more, a little bit, that he's a little bit more reaction to your left leg on the circle. A little bit more reaction. More reach to the left leg. Low. Once more. Medium canter. Never stop him with your reins. And again. Come from your left leg. Left he's a little against the left leg. He's against your left leg. He's against your left leg. Cup. Oh, and right into the trot. Oh, come with your left leg into the trot, and then walk, and then half steps. And when we have a good moment, then we finish the session. Oh, quite good transition into walk with shoulder in. Oh, good. That's it. I think is the way, because now he has the rhythm. I think you can see it. This was in the rhythm. It is not his easiest movement, but I think Jutta, I think it's now more part of your whole process. In the old days, I had always the feeling you did a good job, and then you started the piaf thing, and then you changed your concept, and the horse, what the horse did in a good way, one lost. Transition to walk and a break. And I think we should give an explanation to the spectators what you think.
Felt good, felt much more active. And what I like very much about is going forward and trying.
Yeah. Enough.